What's up, InnerTubers? We are here for two reasons. You get to decide which is more important. The first one, well, I won't say it's the first one. The first one I'm going to tell you is that there has been progress. There are things you need to see. I wanted to play this game, and I cannot play it without showing you what we've done. The other reason is I was real thirsty. I wanted some jingly dope beverage, and making a recording was the best excuse I had. So, the house. When we last left, I think we were maybe standing right here. That wall, let me see, can I point with this thing? Nope. Oh, put your fist away, lady. I'll use the tip of the sword as a pointer. That wall right there was going way up there. This is the second story. We had a third floor up yonder, and then the building was just, it was so tall and ridiculous. We were trying like to do the two different angles there, trying to do some type of saddled roof over here. And I realized when I walked away and just let it percolate, like I suggested, the problem I was having was just, it was just too damn big. So we scaled it back considerably. Let me show you. We'll start from here. We'll talk about all this. Whoa, blurry. We'll talk about all this other stuff here in a momentito. So, this is what we ended up with. And in a minute, we'll run up to that ledge because there's a good vantage point to get an overview of what's going on. So, we ended up just kind of splitting this into two different rooms. I realized this is all the space we need. We don't need more than this. Because we kind of got an outdoor vibe going on, and I wanted to stick with that for this particular base we're living in. So the porch got bigger as a result of... Come here, speeder. Let me show you something I found. Oh, wait, that's not supposed to work. You're not supposed to be able to hit me over the wall. I'm trying to show the people things. Give me your goodness. I don't know which is good, if I want the gossamer or the ichor. And I think the axe favors the ichor, but alright. So, as I was saying, so this porch became a bit more bigger. And then, so this just kind of is like a bedroom area. There's a couple of chests, there's, I don't know. That guy out there is noisy. We'll talk about him in a second. I needed to get rid of the chests that were over there because I wanted that armorer's bench right there. So there's no real rhyme or reason. And then I went with kind of an open roof design up here just so you had a vantage and you could look. And I don't know, at some point, I guess you can enslave the villagers that we can't see right now. And there are some archers, and maybe I'll put them up here, you know, maybe one over in that corner, and maybe they'll start dealing with all these dang spiders and hyenas, like that guy right at the tip of my sword, and his buddy right there, Jumpy McJumperson. So this is what I ended up with the house. I don't love it. I think it's cool. I don't hate it. I hated the first one, and I really wasn't happy with where we were going. I think I got a bit too ambitious. It was too big. So, out here, and we'll get to that in a minute. So, I think there was a forge over here, or maybe it was over there. Yeah, it was right here-ish. I tore it out, and then I made this little forgery hut. I tried a couple of different things. What I really wanted to do was back here, just have the fences like that, but for some reason, without having a wall back there, I couldn't put the roof pieces up. So this is what we ended up with, and I don't know, it's interesting, I guess, and it's like a little, you know, a little forgery place. And then we finally got a blacksmith's bench. I did find iron. I went and did it without you, and I'll show you guys. It's actually not too far away. Up that ramp. So we'll go over there in a second because I need to get some iron. Let me get rid of all this crap. And that. And then we'll put the hide in here. We'll hang on to those and then we'll store Gossamer and Ichor elsewhere. So we've got the blacksmith bench now. It should be churning away on these iron reinforcements. My God, these things take forever. It's like 3 minutes per. It's ridiculous. And then it takes 20 of them to make this large chest, 20 of these, and then 60 shaped woods, which come out of this carpenter's bench that you get for 10 pieces of wood. So basically a stack of wood will give you 10 of these. So that's they're expensive, but they hold a lot more. So I've just got kind of like raw base materials, base materials, but the base, like the lowest level materials. Actual base materials are in here, some of our leftovers. Let me see, is it in here? No. Was it in here? Yes. So we've got a regular bed now. I think we had that last time, but it's been moved down here. We got kind of a little to-go kit with some extra stuff. There's extra armor because we have progressed to a couple of medium pieces. It's these three are all medium level now. You see I'm level 25. So these are the changes in stats. I don't remember where we were last time. And then in the recipes, pardon me a moment. We'd learned that, but I couldn't make it. So I've learned just these. Maybe that's new. I think that is new, actually. Learn this fireball cauldron and the iron broadsword. And then I think that's it. So on that note, we are now using an iron broadsword. And then we've moved on to iron tools, which are kind of a pain. The durability is a bit low, which means you need to carry some. Let's put some coal in there and get the rest of that smelting. I haven't quite figured out how much for how much, so I've been going a little bit on the conservative side, and then we'll stow the rest in here. But I want to keep half. So I'll split that in half with a shift right click. And then I also want to take some of these. We'll take like 20 of them, because it takes iron and leather to repair the iron tools, whereas the sword is repaired with iron alone. And then I'm also carrying a stone sword as well, just for dealing with hyenas and stuff. That's not really going to be that challenging, so I don't use up the durability on this bad boy. Yeah! I got my timing wrong. That's progress. We've got iron. I did have to... Oh, and the carpenter's bench. I don't think that was here before, so that just kind of got tucked over here. I had to tear this pit of yog out because the stairs were kind of coming in. Ooh, we got some light flicker glitcher. Was right here, so I had to tear it out to position it better. I actually tried to stick it up there, but it's got a huge footprint. It didn't fit. So this thing, the lesser wheel of pain, this thing is used for breaking the will of the NPCs that you can capture by knocking them silly with this truncheon. I will smack you until you get sleepy. After you do that, you grab some fiber bindings, and then you can like lasso them up, like rope them, and then you drag them home and you shove them in there. And then the fuel for that thing is food. Oh, speaking of food, let's eat some food and drink some water. And then they tame up, and then they're basically like your slaves. They call them thralls, which is the word they use. I don't know if, when I hear thrall, I think of like Warcraft, but what can you do? So I have not yet tried to tame anybody, or to enslave anybody. This game makes me want to say tame, and I've noticed it in other folks' videos because you can't get away from you can't get away from the similarities to Ark in that game. taming. So the other thing I did was I made stairs that go down there. This took much longer than you would think. Initially, let me get my pointer out. The stairs were, and we're going to use, remember, we're using the edge of the tip of the sword. So the stairs came down here, and then they were coming down this way, but this rock was in the way. So then I tried to turn and come down, you know, this way, but it just wasn't working out. So we ended up with this here, which I think it came out kind of cool. I like it. I like it a lot. Let me get some water. I'm toasty. All right. Well, I'm not toasty, but I'll get toasty. So yeah, I really dig this. I think it came out pretty cool. I think it's got a neat look to it. You know, it's a little bit higgly wiggly squiggly, which is cool. And then there's one thing I did when I logged on just now. It's about to get dark. Let's run up to the hill. And then we'll talk about the torches. All these little torches you can see around, every time I log on, there's no flame. They emit light, you can see, but there's no flame, like just the little graphical flare, the visual goodiness of the fire. Come here, I'm going to have to smash you. You're going to interfere with me trying to show the people things. Get wrecked. Oh, hyena. Hyena! Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, you are hyena. Your profile was freaky when you turned to the side. Get sleepy. Can I have your hide? Please? Please? Pretty? Okay, never mind. I think it's... Yeah, I mean, doesn't that look awesome? I think if we go a little bit farther down... It's getting a little scary because it's dark. I'm going to keep the good sword out. You know, we... Who said that? Are you down there? Maybe he's down there. Doesn't that look awesome? I think that looks really cool. I think the visual flourish of the flickering torches really just brings it home. I think overall I'm pretty pleased with it as a complex. Yeah, I dig it. I think it looks great. Certainly sufficient for ye old starter base. Hey, was he knocking on our door? Do you have a special delivery? Were you bringing flowers? Probably not. Maybe he had a singing telegram. Alright, let's get inside. I feel like something's on our heels. Somebody? I've noticed if they, you know, especially with the hyenas, they'll run right up to the wall and they can't hit you, but you can swing over and kind of smack them down. So, it's dark. Not a whole lot can be shown to you, although I really like the way this kind of lights up at night. Yeah, I think that covers, like, really quickly what's changed. I'm going to repair some of this stuff up. I'm going to unload all of this crazy. And then when the morning comes, we will head out and I will show you where I got the iron. And, oh, yeah. Because there's also something else over there that I'm super interested in, but I did not want to go and look at it without you. So we will go and look at it, because I'm really geeked to figure out what it is, because it looks amazing. All right, so the sun has come up. Let us go has an adventure. Not going to be quite as adventurous for me, because I have... Get some speeder. I learned if you got serpentine helps you get much. God dang it, don't back up. He's a. Ooh, it's an archer. Can we knock him out? Oh, that hurt. Don't do that. Don't stop doing that. Get sleepy. Take a nap. Does this make you tired? Is that making you tired? Maybe I should eat some healthy food. Does this make you tired? I still just get wrecked by these guys. We did it. Oh, he's a level 2. Alright. No, get rid of that. Get that. Let's get out of here before your buddies show up. Look at this shenanigans. It's just ridiculous and I love it. Oh man. What's that? What is the, oh, you can see the shadow from the rope, but I don't have a shadow. I'm ethereal. Isn't that bananas? Oh, and his buddy just showed up. We got out of there just in the nick of time. Come here, mister. Alright, so I think if we just hit E. Swoop. There he is. Alright, we need some food. Okay, so overnight, let me get rid of that and then put that back. Overnight, I did turn this bonfire on. You guys saw me shoving all that meat in there. I don't know how much food it's going to take to feed this fella. What's the music for? Oh, hey you. Get out of here. Oh, we leveled. Awesome. Ta-da! Alright, let's shove some meats in here. And turn it on. Oh, that's 3 hours worth of meat. I feel like that should be enough. Certainly enough time for us to get back. And then, the other thing I've never touched, let's do it. You take some plant fibre. This is just rumor, to be honest with you. And some seeds. And I think the two of these combine to make gruel. Only get 28 gruel, huh? It would be nice if they showed you like what was involved. Is it like, does it need more fibers? Does it need more seeds? Let's put more seeds and see what happens. Nope. Alright, so it's the fiber. Oh man, it's definitely the fiber. Oh, dang it, spider. Come on, man, I'm burning daylight. I wanna go show the people shredded roast. Yeah, that means it's cooked, doesn't it? So we could put that in there. Get over here. Get smashed. Alright. Oh, see, now our inventory's a wreck. Dang it, we're burning daylight. I'm hurrying, I promise, I'm hurrying. Get that, get rid of that, more. Drop. Alright, we'll go out this way. Alright, now let's go. Oh man, I'm so excited, we're gonna get an archer and we're gonna put him up on the roof. I hope he protects us, I wonder what their range is. I don't really know a whole lot about them. But I'll tell you what, I'm super excited about that. Alright, let me switch to the stone sword. Oh, I also learned. Oh, serpentine. Ka-cha! Alright, so let me intentionally burn up my staminas. Because I learned something. Alright, so we'll burn it out. And then I'm just going to stop running and walk. And it kind of comes back a little bit slowly. And then I stop walking. And it comes back like that quickly. Now, let me burn it up again, because there's something even more better, I think. I bet that sound effect's annoying. Or humorous, I hope. Watch this, if I crouch, I feel like that's faster. I may have to watch in the footage and actually do some timing. If standing still and crouching are different, but somehow that feels faster. No. Oh, you know what I forgot to do? I forgot to fix up our armor. Oh no, our headpiece busted. Can we repair it a little bit at least? A little bit. Dang it! We're gonna end up... This one? Oh, man. Can you give me some hide? Do you have hide? Oh yeah, you're full of hide. Alright, repair that. And then repair that. No, stay back. So yeah, alright, these are repaired, I think. Oh no, I used up all of our leather. Oh man. Dang it. Alright, we're gonna drop that. I'm so scattered right now, I'm so sorry. We're gonna drop that. Alright, we'll keep that, and we'll keep that. Because I do want to come back with some iron. from our trip. All right, so I learned. So, look at that freaky guy. I ended up having to fight one of them once. He's not as scary as he looks. I came up this way once when I first got over here. And I think I've alluded to it that I'd gone up this way. But this is as far as I went. And I jumped on that rock and kind of looked over. I'll show you. And I hear that noise every time I come over here. So now I know what it is making that noise. It freaks me out. There's like a village down there. Oh, you're scary sounding. Down there is a little village. Let's get out of here, because that's not what we're here for. Crippled? How did I get crippled? What crippled me? Is there a ghost hyena in the rocks? Alright, so we came around that corner. If we go up this away. Oh my gosh, this episode's already running. I got 28 minutes of recording. I think there's only about 4 or 5 minutes I'm cutting out. Well, maybe at the beginning. Because gosh dang, this game takes a long while to load. So we're probably maybe in the 20 minute range. Dang it. Time's flying. Yeah, so we come up here. There's not much going on along this path. Oh, but that's what I want to go check out. Maybe we'll have to do... I'll show you the iron. We'll take the load back, and then... You know, we'll make another episode out of what the heck is that? Because that looks super groovy. Man, that looks really cool too up there. Anyways, getting sidetracked. I'm so excited. So much has happened. And there's things I want to do, but I didn't want to do them without you. This looks so intriguing. I wonder if there's like a priest or something. It looks like some kind of religious temple, doesn't it? I think that little pink thing right there at the tip of the sword. I kind of feel like that looks like the Mitra god symbol or something. So there's some spiders up here that are nasty. But I found a tactic that works when I come up here. That is hide behind this rock. Get their attention. There's one of them. All right, now they're aware. Then you hide behind this rock. And then a couple will come from that way. You end up having to face a couple of them initially. Alright, let's go. There we go. I knew there was a couple. I feel like I usually end up facing four of them right away. So really? There's only two? I know there's some hiding in these bushes over here. Check it out. That's iron right there. There's one. Serpentine. Serpentine. Oh, don't lock up, game. Alright, there he is. And then I usually just try to run this way to get away. And then it's clear and I can see. And then we get a good vantage point. Oh, what the heck is that? There's people. I see a person right there. Oh, it looks like there's another one right there. But check it out. Irons. So this is where the iron has been coming from. And I learned... the iron pick. Whoa. My neighbors just started a really loud vehicle. I wonder if you could hear that. Gives you 3 times the amount of resources out of it. It's one hit, I get 21. I used to get 7 or 9 or something. There he is. He's got a friend. Well, I think that rock protected us. First time I came up here with just the stone. Actually, I didn't even have a stone sword. I had that stone javelin. And I've really determined that the swords are just way better. They're just so much faster and easier to hit things. Like the javelin apparently has range, but it's really precise where you get like a sweeping attack with the sword. I feel like it's just better in every regard, every aspect. Alright, we're about to get fat. Yep, it happened. We got fat. So, we can drop that. We definitely don't need this flesh. Or that flesh. Food? What? I ate it? How'd that happen? Accidentally ate it. Dang it. So, we can probably get a little bit more. I don't want to get overburdened and I don't want to waste it. Alright, so let's leave it at that. But that's 540. So that's what, 270. Fall damage is friendly. That hurt a little bit, but not too bad. Wonder how long that food poisoning lasts. And what the actual result of that is. I really want to know what's going on over there. Ooh, and I really want to know about this Archer 2. Oh man, I'm so excited. I just made that Wheel of Pain. I think that was the last thing I did. And then I realized that it kind of had... Oh, look at that. All right, so I'm going to crouch. I really feel like that helps. What if I stand up? Crouch. I don't think that makes any difference at all. I think I got duped. Somebody tricked me. Maybe that one of the parts of that food poisoning is that our health... Oh, it is going down. It's very slowly going down. But normally it would very slowly go up. So let's eat a little bit of human breast. Oh, that sounded really bad. I was thinking like chicken breast. You know, like a piece of... Never mind. I also noticed that the local wildlife, when it's not glitching, will fight each other. And you can use that to your advantage to make your escape. Alright, so what I'm going to do is run back, deal with this iron, probably wait out this food poisoning, which means we might end up waiting out this day. I don't really have any particular plans set aside for the iron. I just know that I want a lot of it. Oh, yeah. There was something I wanted to ask you guys about. Nope. Oh, I'm out of stamina. I can't attack. You can't attack when you have no stamina. That is good to know. Oh, please. Please die. That could have gone really badly. Oh, dang it. Now I'm carrying too much. Drop that. Dang it. We're about to get attacked too, huh? Let's get out of here. No speeder. Alright, you wait over there. I got some things. 1, 2... And then half of that, and half of that. And then you can have all of that, and then we'll stick some other stuff in there in a minute. Jeez. Almost, things got almost a little exciting there, didn't they? I tell you what, alright, we'll take it off since we can hold it now. I ended up up there once. And I died up there. It was when I first got the iron, the path we just went on down that way, and then we kind of go around, and there's a way to go up, and it circles up to here, and I just wanted to see what was up there. And I got overrun, and I died up there, and it was, you know, I had these two were my only iron things, and I had totally exhausted my supplies to get it, and I was really bummed. I almost logged out because I was like, oh, there's no way in hell I'm getting back up there. But I did manage to get back up there and get things recovered, so that was cool. What was it I wanted to talk to you guys about? Oh, yeah. So I've been going that way a lot. So a thought that I had was maybe tearing out this fence right here and building an elevated walkway that goes over and eventually rises up to that ledge to let me skip all of this crap. But I'm worried. I think functionally it'd be fantastic. Because when I go there, I have to go around over that way. So it would save a little bit of time. I think it'd be pretty quick to build. But I wonder what it would look like if there was a walkway coming out, you know, and then going up over to that. I don't know if that would just look silly. Maybe, you know, instead of doing the walkway, you know, we just come over here and we just, you know, put a staircase up there. You know, maybe that's a better answer. I'm not sure. So, I'd like feedback, please. So use the interactables, and oh, what a great segue. So that's going to be the end of this episode. So let me know what you think about the bridge or just a staircase or something. And then maybe even, I think I am going to do a staircase all the way up there. I don't remember if there was anything up there worth going up there for. But it's a hill, so it needs to be climbed. Just because it's up there. We have to have access. So let me know. Let me know what you think about how this has turned out. You know, all the things. Ooh, how's this progressing? Oh my gosh, that's going to take forever. Wow. Okay, we're going to have to cook up more mitts. Give me some wood. So go down to the interactables. Give me some feedback on the questions I've asked. And then use them in any other way you see fit. And stay classy.